Sometimes, bands got sick of a project because it simply became too popular and, in turn, too confining. Other times, something just went terribly wrong along the way. However they got there, each ended up on a rarefied list of classic rock artists who hate their own records. Here's a look at five of the most notable examples. The Beatles, Let It Be. Paul McCartney openly groused about the wall of sound approach favored by producer Phil Spector, while John Lennon served up a classic backhanded compliment, given the load of badly recorded with a lousy feeling to it, he made something of it. Black Sabbath, Never Say Die. Geezer Butler later admitted the title was completely tongue-in-cheek, as Black Sabbath sank into a mire of chemical, creative, and interpersonal difficulties. None of that made for a great album. Ozzy Osbourne, who was subsequently fired, called this the worst piece of work I've ever had anything to do with. I'm ashamed of that album. I think it's disgusting. Emerson, Lake & Palmer, Love Beach. Born out of an attempt to make more radio-friendly songs, this misstep sent the band into retirement until the early 90s. I always refer to it as the worst album that ELP ever made, Carl Palmer said. Not only did the music not really stand up for me, but the album cover, I didn't like it. The soon-to-depart Ace Frehley never thought a concept album by Kiss would work. In fact, he was so appalled by the idea that he refused to come into the studio, instead shipping guitar parts he recorded at home in Connecticut to the studio via FedEx. Later, Paul Stanley admitted that Elder was pompous, contrived, self-important, and fat. Worse, he added, it was mediocre. The Who, It's Hard. It's Hard should never have been released, singer Roger Daltrey said. I had huge rows with Pete Townsend. I said, Pete, this is just a complete piece, and it should never come out. Townsend could be self-critical. He even called 1969's Pinball Wizard awful and the most clumsy piece of writing I've ever done.